We're often asked about the right specification of laptops for CAD and related engineering workflows. These tend to fall into three categories. Customers who are buying a new software license are looking for the best laptop to run that solution. Existing customers who are looking to upgrade their old workstation, or customers looking to improve performance. Now, the key for CAD is a modern CPU with high single-threaded performance, a certified professional graphics card, and enough memory and storage to make sure that you won't run out. However, comparing all the specifications can still be a minefield, with thousands of possible combinations. As with their desktop workstations, Dell split their laptops into three ranges. The Precision 3000 series of entry-level laptops, 5000 series offering powerful ultra-portable laptops, and the 7000 series of desktop replacement workstations. Now, you might think we would always just recommend the top-of-the-line workstations, but it's not that simple. We do a lot of testings to come up with our optimal recommended workstations, and to illustrate the point, when it comes to the top-performing laptops, our recommendations of which series to choose is almost the opposite of our desktop recommendations. For the Dell Precision 3000 and 5000 series, the updates for 2024 bring a big change from Intel. For the first time since 2006, there's a change of branding with the release of their Ultra series of CPUs. It's not too different to get your head around. For now, you're looking for the Intel Ultra 3 to 9 series, rather than the old Core i3 to i9 branding. Beyond the branding change, these new Ultra CPUs feature dedicated hardware for AI workloads and two new ultra-low power cores to further increase battery life. They are the first CPUs to use Intel's new 4-node for process technology, cramming even more transistors into an ever smaller space, and also improving efficiency. The other update to the Precision 3000 and 5000 series is that Nvidia have updated their low-end cards to the latest Ada generation. While we don't typically recommend these lower-end cards for SOLIDWORKS CATIA, if you are dealing with 2D or light 3D workloads, these new cards could be a good option. This leaves the top of the line Precision 7000 series. While there are no new Intel Ultra CPUs in this range, it's down to the process not being mature enough to support the top of the line desktop and laptop CPUs yet. The only change therefore for 2024 is an update on the low-end graphics cards to the latest Nvidia Ada generation. So what does this mean for our recommendations? Does the Precision 7000 series still offer the best performance, or are the new systems with the Intel Ultra CPUs a better choice? We compared the most powerful models in the Precision 3000 and 5000 series with these Intel Ultra CPUs against a Precision 7680 with mid-range specs, and also a top-of-the-range Precision 7780. Then, for some context, we also compared all of these against an older Precision 7750 laptop from 2020. See how much performance improvement there has been in just a few years. Starting off with a typical CAD rebuild test, this relatively complex part with over 50 features has to be rebuilt one feature at a time. Therefore, it's mainly single-threaded in nature, as one feature must be generated before the next one can begin to calculate. As our baseline, this takes 49 seconds on our Precision 7750 laptop dating from 2020. The latest Precision 3000 and 5000 series laptops take around 35 seconds, clearly showing there is a benefit to upgrading to a modern workstation laptop. However, the Precision 7680 is almost twice as fast as the laptop from 2020, taking just over 26 seconds to rebuild this model, and our Precision 7780 shaves a further second off of this time. We saw similar results with other CAD tasks, such as opening this customer dataset of the Nemo submarine. With 6000 components opening in fully resolved mode, it took just over 2 minutes on our 2020 laptop. Precision 3000 and 5000 series laptops are around 25% faster than our high-end laptop from 2020. But again, the Precision 7680 is significantly faster, taking just 1 minute and 9 seconds. And our Precision 7780 shaves another few seconds off this time. Next, we'll compare the graphics capabilities of the different models. Now, despite all the laptops now featuring the latest Ada generation graphics cards across the range, it will be interesting to compare the different levels of cards and also the different power limits across the different laptops. First, we'll look at the performance of rotating the Nemo submarine dataset in SOLIDWORKS, shaded with edges mode, real view graphics, and shadows active. Our 2020 laptop manages a credible 39 frames per second. However, even our entry-level system with its RTX 2000 Ada generation graphics manages 43 frames per second. Now, the next two laptops have the same RTX 3500 Ada generation graphics, while the Precision 5690 is strangely not that much faster than our 3591 at 50 frames per second, the larger 7680 with the same graphics card perform much better, with an average of 68 frames per second. Now this is a larger difference than we would have expected, and we're hopeful that an update in future will address this, but as you'll see in the next section, these did perform much better in visualization tasks. Now SOLIDWORKS Visualize led the way with using the compute power of Nvidia graphics cards for rendering, before then building upon this with the support for Nvidia's dedicated hardware for AI denoising and ray trace rendering to deliver the results in ever faster times. And we equipped our Precision 3591 with the most powerful graphics card it supports, although this is limited to around 40 watts in this system. The Precision 5000 and 7000 series support much higher end cards with higher power limits. Now, the performance of the latest laptops is very impressive, with our 2020 laptop taking around 4 minutes and 30 seconds to render this scene. Even our entry level laptop betters this, taking 3 minutes and 43 seconds. Moving up to the Precision 5000 and 7000 series, our Precision 5690 takes 2 minutes and 7 seconds, while the Precision 7680 takes 2 minutes dead. If we throw in the top of the range Precision 7780 with the most powerful RTX 5000 8th generation graphics, this took just 1 minute and 29 seconds. And if you're interested in simulation, you might not be surprised to find that our recommendation is still going to be the Precision 7000 series of laptops, with more cores running at higher speeds and power limits than the rest of the range. Our 2020 laptop takes nearly 7 minutes to complete our test simulation, whereas our current Precision 3000 and 5000 series laptops cut that down to just over 4 minutes. But again, the Precision 7000 series leads the way over twice the speed of our 2020 laptop. The difference is even larger for flow simulation, with a study that took 1 hour and 50 minutes on our 2020 laptop, taking less than an hour on our Precision 3000 and 5000 series laptops, and between 39 and 42 minutes on our Precision 7000 series laptops. To sum up our recommendations, the Precision 3000 series laptops continue to offer a lot of performance in an affordable package, but are best focused on the core CAD modeling workflows. The Precision 5690 blends the portability of increased power both for the CPU and the graphics cards. However, while Intel's new Ultra CPUs offer better power efficiency and therefore battery life, right now they're not the highest performance choice for CAD. This illustrates why we go to all this effort with real-world tests before recommending workstations. It's easy to be swayed by the latest products, however, it remains the case if you want the ultimate CAD, simulation and visualization performance, the Precision 7000 series is our recommendation. To see our range of recommended workstations, check out our website or get in touch for more advice.